Gotcha. 09.
Well, it's a beautiful Saturday night here in Columbus, Mississippi. A beautiful Saturday night to pay out over $70,000 to the best dirt late model drivers around as they try to tame the mag. It is going to be a battle of talent as they get set to go.
249093.
All right, well, we're going to get them up 4x4. Race fans, it is time to get on your feet. As drivers from all across the United States have come to Columbus, Mississippi to put on a show for you, the greatest fans on the planet, as they form up four wide out of turns 3 and 4. They can hear you in those race cars. They can see. Put your hands in there. Make some noise. The Stars and Cars, the 2017 Magnolia State Cotton Pickin 100 presented by Cooper's Country Meat Packers. All right, back straightaway. We didn't forget about you. This Premier Ford main event is rolling their way. That's right. Flash the lights. Get ready to let them know you're ready to see a show down the back straightaway in the party zone. Speed zone parking. Wave at them. Flash your lights. Make a little bit of noise as the field thunders past you.
You got your 50-50 tickets out. Ticket number 249-0903. 249-0903. You got ticket number, that ticket number, say these young ladies in the front of the tower, get your money. 249-0903. And here they come. Backs, double foul. Jonathan Davenport will break them out.
So, race fans, who wants to see Jonathan Davenport win here tonight?
Well, he's out front. How about Chad Thrash?
What about Tennessee's Dane Dacus?
And Winfield, Tennessee's Mike Marler.
Who just wants to see a good show here at the MAG tonight?
There you go. That's what we want to see, a good race.
Look at that, Ross. Lights have gone down on the Speedway. It is party time for 100 laps. Big money on the line, and it's Davenport and Thrash coming your way.
That's right. They'll come to the Tool Time starting box here. Jonathan Davenport, Chad Thrash. Set the pace of the field of cars. They're in the box, they're on the gas. Here they come. And it's Davenport taking them down into turn number one.
Thrash does not get a good start. He's going to fall way back as he went hot, got into the loose stuff. Meanwhile, out front, Davenport, your leader. Dane Dacus second in the third spot. It'll be Marler. They'll think about three wide for the third spot off of turn number four. Lap number one to Jonathan Davenport.
Davenport leads lap number one. Dane Dacus right there with him, along with Mike Marler, Rick Rickman, Timothy Culp. Your top five. Here comes Billy Moyer making a move in the 21.
The Hall of Famer into the top five. Out front, we may have a new leader. Lap number two. Yep, count it. New leader,
Dane Dacus.
Dacus goes to the lead. Davenport going to battle back to his inside. Two laps, two leaders as they battle down the back straightaway.
Rick Rickman rides in the third spot. Here comes Mike Marler in the 157 car. You've got Culp in the C8 car. You've got the 18 of Michael Page. He's going to be a factor in this race as well.
Davenport back to the lead. Dacus in second. Back in third, Rick Rickman in the fourth spot. It's going to be car 157 of Mikey Marler. Right at your top five right now, it's going to be Timothy Culp. Michael Page outside looking in. They're two and three wide back through the pack as this racetrack is cleaning up nicely.
It is cleaning up. You'll see some of the blacks starting to come into it in three and four. So Davenport, about a half a straightaway lead over you. And Mike Marler makes a move on Dacus to go to the bottom of the racetrack, and he's got second right now.
I think Marler said it may be go time early in this one. What a big slaughter. Dacus battles back to his inside. We'll see if Marler can clear him off four. No, Marler almost got into the fence. He'll diamond that corner back off. Good stuff for the second spot. Meanwhile, Davenport's got a half a straightaway lead.
Mike Marler now in second. Dacus had it as a stripe. Here comes Dane Dacus battling back along with Timothy Culp. And Rick Rickman has stuck his nose up in the top five.
Out front right now, you got the 2017 World 100 and Hillbilly 100 champion. In second, the 2017 Knoxville Nationals champion. And in third, a guy that's only run about a dozen races this year. And now Timothy Culp with a big slaughter on Dane Dacus. Can he make it stick? And Timothy Culp up to third. Timothy Culp got his biggest win of his career earlier this year with a World of Outlaws win down at Lone Star Speedway. And he and Dacus, a good battle for third while your leader has caught lap traffic as we complete lap number nine.
Lap traffic is going to be a factor for your leader with less than 10 laps to go. Here he goes around Austin Redding in the 94 car.
He's going to come up on Chandler Petty next. That's the next car he'll lap. Is right now Jonathan Davenport. That time by, we'll see if the separation is back to Mike Marler. 2.1 seconds. We'll see if lap traffic affects that whatsoever.
Robbie Stewart right in front of your leader now in the 6R car. Davenport has stretched the lead out now by about a straightaway over Mike Marler.
That time by, Marler knocks 2/10 off his lead, though, as Davenport's searching around. And down the back straightaway, Marler now in lap traffic. We'll see how he can negotiate it. Mike Marler winning the clash at the Mag here back in June with Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series. And he's on a rail, and that time by Ross, half a second off the lead of Jonathan Davenport.
Knocked a half a second off of it here. Mike Marler begins to close the gap as Lap Cars is in front of your leader here in 3 and 4.
Timothy Culp back in third in the fourth spot now. Dane Dacus, fifth, going to be Rick Rickman. Billy Moyer in sixth. Chad Thrash in seventh. Page in eighth. Sullivan in ninth. And it'll be Chris Wall rounding out your top ten.
As they battle down the backside, you still got Lap Cars, Davenport right in the middle of the mix, and Mike Marler right behind the 27 of Nick Thrash as he tries to work to the bottom of the racetrack down in turn one.
And a big slaughter by Davenport, and he's not able to clear the three-wide battle with the Lap Cars of Stewart and Hunter Rasden. And right now, this racetrack is beautiful. They are running top to bottom, and here comes Mike Marler. He's only a car length behind your leader. The battle for the lead with 15 laps complete. Big slide job, new leader off turn number two, Mike Marler.
Mike Marler, your new leader down the back straightaway. He's got Davenport pinned behind the lap car, but he slides up, and Mike Marler will lead lap number 16.
Three leaders in the first 16 laps. Welcome to Magnolia Motor Speedway, race fans, as now Davenport closes back in on Marler, who loses all of his momentum, and a big slider from Davenport. Nope, he thinks better of it. Marler will keep the lead. It's Culp back in third, and in fourth, prowling around the high side, it's Dane Dacus fifth, now Billy Moyer.
And Mike Marler and Dane Dacus know they've got to keep the nose clean on those cars right now. We're still early in this race. We're not even a quarter of the way through, but Mike Marler still leads them.
And it's going to be Mike Marler going to work. He'll put a lap on Neil Baggett, that brand-new Rocket XR1. He'll slide him off at two. That allows Davenport to close back in, three car lengths back. 19 laps complete out of turn number four, and it is chaotic racing for the lead through lap traffic.
Davenport back to the rear bumper of Marler as he takes the top shelf. Marler around the bottom, has that top side momentum, got something. Here comes Davenport. He'll take the lead going into three. We got a caution.
We got Austin Reddick down the front straightaway just as Jonathan Davenport goes for the lead, and caution will fly.
And we'll go back to last completed lap.
Well, with 19 laps down, race fans, what do you think so far? What a race here tonight we've got. Well, we're getting ready to turn the lights out. It's hard to believe we've still got 81 laps remaining.
81 laps remain, race fans. Can you sit in your seats for 81 more laps?
What kind of signals did Mike Marler's crew chief, Josh Davis, give him under caution?
You see them all down by that fence up in turn number one and two.
What did Brian Liverman tell the number 49 of Jonathan Davenport? We're going back green out of turn number four.
There they come. Green's back up. Marler leads them down into turn number one. You got Davenport. You got Culp. You got Dacus. You got Rickman. You're top five.
And
here comes the old man, Billy Moyers, at three wide back in turn three.
Right now that top's awfully good. It takes a little bit of momentum getting built up on the bottom to make it work. And right now they're going to tap dance around the high side. Marler, your leaders. We work lap 21 out of turn number two. In second, it's going to be Davenport. Back in third now, Dane Dacus and Rick Rickman, hometown driver, back into the top four.
Hey, dude, I'm watching back in the field. There's flat job city everywhere back there.
Look at the Intimidator. He's down in the weeds on the bottom. He's trying to march his way forward.
He's up to the eighth spot.
He knows what it's like to win a Cotton Pickin 100, a Magnolia State 100. And right now, though,
Michael
top Page is
Michael Page trying to do the chop job down here.
The Gator's going to get him if he isn't careful. Three wide back in the pack, and we got caution as Brian Rickman. And now what you got to wonder, Ross, did he choose the wrong tires? Is there something? Ooh. Is he going to the pits at this point?
Well, he's got 22 complete. He's got 78 laps to go.
He's got plenty
of time to go to the pits if he needs to put another tire on that car, and that's exactly where he's headed.
He's not going to be the last one to go to the work area before the halfway mark of this one. You could see a front runner doing that as well.
Look at Ross Bales. He's up to 15th.
Yeah. We're really glad to have Ross Bales here this weekend, as we said, the Barry Wright House Car Program. A lot of diversity in this field this weekend, but right now it's the Rocket XR1. Mike Marler leading the way with 78 laps remaining.
22 complete, 78 to go. The caution light is out. Here comes Marler on the gas. Davenport right behind him.
Dane Dakins gets a better start that time. He'll see if he can do anything with Davenport from a second spot. The top's been the place to be. Dakins going to drive all the way across the track. No, not all the way, because Davenport tiptoes past him. Here comes Culp. He brings Rick Rickman with him, that battle for third.
Billy Moyer trying to make a move. They're four wide for fifth. Who's going to have it? It's going to be Rickman, and he's going to bring Moyer with him.
And we got a battle for the lead, Ross. Don't look now, but the black ice is waking up.
It's waking up. Davenport and Marler. Davenport's going to slide up. Here comes Marler to the inside. Marler will hang on to the lead.
Mike Marler, your leader, 24 laps in the books. Davenport threw a slider at him, testing the waters. Now it's going to be Marler about four car lengths. It's half a straightaway back to Dane Dakins in third. Then it's going to be Culp, Rick Rickman, Billy Moyer. That's your top six, as Davenport may be setting up another slide job as they battle for the lead off into one.
Down through one they go off of turn number two. He's going to follow the 157 car along with Dakins and Culp. Rick Rickman. Moyer looked like slowed up a little bit off of two, getting back in the gas. Here comes Cadillac Jack Sullivan.
Sullivan on the move as we got a battle for the lead. Slider through one and two. It's Marler up top right through the middle of Davenport. And Marler says, no, sir. The Winfield Warrior stays out front. Superman's going to put his cape in the wind and go to the cushion. Who's going to lead? Lap number 27.
Well,
it's Mike Marler.
Mike Marler, but here comes Davenport in the bottom this time.
Another big slider from Davenport. Can Marler drive down the hill? He's going to try. Your battle off into three and four. I think you're going to have another leader. We complete lap 28. Another lead change.
Who's it going to be?
Mark it down. Another lead change with 28 down. Davenport to the lead.
Davenport takes the lead on lap number 28. Side by side. Marler right there with him. He's going to let him go this time into turn three. He's going to put him up by the concrete. Marler's going to go right with him. Here comes Timothy Culp in the bottom.
I keep thinking these boys are going to ride for a few laps, but it's not happening. And caution on the Speedway, Hunter Rasden. I don't know if I can take 100 laps, Ross. I don't know if I got it in me, buddy.
I'm getting old. I'm 62 years old. I don't know if my heart can stand halfway through
now
this.
Now, look, if Moyer's going to keep racing, you got to keep announcing. That's the trade-off, buddy.
Oh, he's going to be cutting donuts. Yeah.
If Jack Sullivan wins, we're going to need a translator in victory lane.
Yes.
Look, I'm from Memphis. I don't know what language he speaks. It's Arkansas-ing, but... He was actually born like in St. Martin, I think, and that explains a lot. Jack Sullivan was not a legal citizen until a few years ago, and I'm not even making that up. He was born in like St. Martin,
yeah,
the Virgin Islands.
He acts like he's not.
It makes a lot of sense.
He's an illegal alien, don't he?
Yeah, he's a good guy unless he's trying to cheat you out of something.
Absolutely.
All right, well, it's Davenport bringing us back to the green. 28 laps down, 72 to go. Davenport goes way up high, and we go green. Did he leave the door open? No, he didn't.
No, he did not. Mike Marler.
Or did he, Ross?
Hey, Marler's in the lead. He slides up. Here comes Davenport. He's got a diamond it off the backside down the chute. It comes. It's going to be side by side through three. Davenport slides up. Mike Marler going tucky and right behind him.
They were only four wide behind your leaders. That's all. As Marler's going to try to go through the bottom. He'll slide in front of Davenport. Davenport down the hill. This is what you paid to see.
They've got that figured out. They know when he goes, he's going to dive to the inside.
And looking third while they're dicing it up, Dane Dakins is trying to score the upset of the year in car 54. Here comes Cadillac Jack.
Cadillac Jack.
He's up to fifth.
He's up beside Timothy Culp. Kyle Brunson. Look at Kyle Brunson in the 40 car. He started way
22nd,
back.
22nd,
up to 6th. He does not give up, my friends.
Kyle Bronson has been on the road most of this year, and he told me he wanted this one as bad as he wanted anything, and right now he's knocking on the top five. He'll run in fifth down the back straightaway. Davenport, your leader, 32 on the board off turn number four. It'll be Marler in second, Dakins in third, Culp in fourth, and 22nd to fifth. Here comes Kyle Bronson.
Kyle Brunson, the man on the move right now in the 40 car. But it looks like Superman, Jonathan Davenport, begins to stretch that lead out a little bit over Mike Marler. Can they hold up? Marler may be holding back a little bit, maybe saving some tire for later on in the race. They're not even to the halfway point yet.
Well, you got to expect there's got to be a long green flag run at some point, and right now they might do just a little bit of riding around the top of this Magnolia Motor Speedway, but they're going to get closer and closer to that wall, and that's when it's going to really get interesting.
It is, as they're about to put it up there. You'll see the black strip coming in up around the berm here as they come through three and four. We've got a car slow right there. Robbie Stewart looks like he gathers his car up. And here comes your leaders down the front side.
So your top five or six around the top, back in the pack, they're still two and three wide as they continue to clean this racetrack up. And the second half of this race is really going to be interesting to see if these guys can maintain. Right now, the pace has dropped off about half a second for your leaders. They were turning 14.8s, they're turning 15.3s now as we work lap number 37. And Ross, lap traffic is now about to be reality once again.
It is reality for your leaders here as they get out in the back straightaway up through three and four. Lap cars all in front of them. Robbie Stewart will be the first car. Marler still hanging on, along with Dacus, Culp, Kyle Bronson in the fifth spot now.
Well, let's see if Davenport does a slide job over Robbie Stewart. He thinks about it through turns three and four. This is going to allow Marler to close back in. Marler flirts with the wall, though. He about got the mag wall down in turns three and four. Right now, your leader dealing with lap traffic as Marler goes to the bottom. The battle for the lead getting tighter and tighter.
Closing the gap there. It's Davenport. He has to shoot to the top of the racetrack there in turn three to get around the lap car of Robbie Stewart. Here they come. Marler right there.
Oh, we have one slow in front of him. Chandler,
oh, did you see that move
wow.
right there? Did Davenport pull it off?
That could have been disastrous.
Wow.
Chandler Petty going to call it a night, and he just about took Jonathan Davenport with him as Davenport had to take a base of action. And we got contact. Dacus and Culp. Culp not going to stop, though. He's going to lose two spots in Days of Thunder style. We're going to stay green, and he only loses
wow.
two spots.
40 complete.
Oh, look out. Culp's got a flat. I think Culp's got a tire going down.
Culp's got a tire, looks like, going down on the C8
car. We're
going to
stay green, though. He bounces off the wall. Meanwhile, how about fourth place, Kyle Bronson, and he's coming after Dane Dacus. The killer is on a mission tonight as Timothy Culp's got trouble and might be rear-end trouble on that C8 car as he comes by.
Mostly no tires
wow.
down
wow.
on the C8 car.
He's back up to speed. Looks like rear-ended.
Bronson raking the wall down here in turn number four.
As your leaders go through lap traffic, Davenport, your leader, he's gone around Ross Bells. He's gone around the 27 of Nick Thrash, but he's got company now as here comes Mike Marler, and that battle for the lead getting tighter and tighter now, less than a second as we work lap 44 off turn two.
Working hard down the back straightaway. They've got a lap car between them now. It's going to be the one car, B.J. Robinson. Here comes Mike Marler around the bottom. He'll slide up to go behind Davenport as B.J. Robinson hangs around the top of the racetrack.
All you need to know about this track is your two leaders are running a different line every lap as they're searching. They know this place changes. They know rarely does it go one lane. And can we stay green? Oh, Moyer's going to be out. Moyer's going to stop on the bottom. We were
oh.
about to get heavy lap traffic, and Billy Moyer's going to draw a caution. Caution with 45 down, and this could be the time when a guy like Billy Moyer makes wholesale changes in the pits.
Tell you what, 45 laps complete. We're five laps away from being halfway through. The caution flag comes out for the 21 car, the Batesville, Arkansas's Billy Moyer.
Well, should be getting ready. Yep, we're going to give him one to go next time by. Again, after this one, we'll have Victory Lane Ceremony, Street Stock main event coming up. You don't want to miss that one.
Absolutely
not. Three drivers
not.
Battling for the championship.
30 laps will be the distance for that race as well.
These guys know that that's a hard act, too, to top.
Absolutely.
Those Street Stocks put on a show. Well, Ross, lights are down. We got 55 laps to go, and it's Davenport at the point. What can Bronson do? We're about to find out.
We're fixing to find out. Marler chose the inside this time. Here they come as they fire them up.
And Bronson, they better not leave the top open down at one and two, and Davenport won't as Bronson going to get right up on the concrete. Dane Dacus on the inside. They go three wide behind your leaders. It's Davenport, Marler, and Bronson.
Look at Big Sexy throwing his moves in there as well.
Right
three.
Through the middle. Look at that. We've seen nobody straight through the middle, and here comes Brandon Overton. And he's going to do it down in turns one and two as well. He'll go past Dane Dacus into third. Here comes Brandon Overton.
Brandon Overton, the man on the move right now. In the 116 car, Davenport has showed the way. Here comes Marler.
Good battles right now. Right now, you've got your World 100 winner, your Knoxville winner, and your Firecracker winner running 1, 2, 3. And Kyle Bronson back in fourth. Dane Dacus in fifth. Jack Sullivan sixth. Caleb Ashby, great run going in seventh. In the eighth spot, it'll be the 86 of Rickman. Ninth going to be Wall. Tenth will be Michael Page as he battles with the 90 of Brian Rickman.
I don't know what spot, but they're three and four wide back to the back of the field here as they race around. Here comes Davenport all by himself out front. Marler right there in second is Overton. Bronson and Dacus, your top five.
How much higher can Jonathan Davenport get down in turns three and four? That is
you
the question.
You cannot get no higher.
Look at that. flirting with disaster. Cue up the Molly Hatchet as they're working around
That's
the top
exactly
side of the Speedway.
Right.
And we're halfway home, Ross.
50 laps complete, 50 laps to go. It's all Davenport right now, but Mike Marler still in striking distance along with big, sexy Brandon Overton.
That's your top three with 51 on the board. And pretty soon it's time to start showing your hand as you can't let those leaders get too far away from you. They work off into turns three and four. Lap traffic again going to be a reality in a hurry for your leader, Jonathan Davenport, who last time by had a 2-second lead.
Moyer back to the pit.
He'll call it a night. Culp's going to slow a little bit out of turn number two. I think he may be trying to get to the infield, perhaps, to call it a night. We'll see. Either way, four wide lap cars in front of your leader. Where do you go if you're Jonathan Davenport?
Anywhere you want to go right now. He's full of lap cars, though, right in front of him.
So we'll watch and see if Marler and Overton can make up any ground as heavy lap traffic in front of your leader. As he works off turn number four now with 54 laps complete, Mike Marler knocks 5/10 off of Jonathan Davenport's lead. Is Marler better on the long runs?
Maybe, but lap traffic, like we said, lap cars right in front of Davenport here. He's going to slow him up probably just a little bit. Can Marler catch him down in turn one and two?
That time by, they maintain about the same separation as Davenport trying to clear the lap cars in front of him.
Davenport bobbling off of turn number two.
Oh, he'll push a little bit through turns three and four. Marler trying to get around Timothy Culp. He knows this is a chance to make up ground on your leader, and he's going to knock 3/10 off his lead. As Davenport's giving up the top, he's gone to the middle. Is this racetrack going through another transition here tonight?
It could be changing, but Davenport right through the middle down in turn number three and four brings it back to the top side down the front straightaway.
57 laps complete, 43 to go. Mike Marler 1.6 seconds back. Overton's half a straightaway back in the third spot. Fourth is Bronson. Fifth now is going to be Dane Dakins with Jack Sullivan working on him.
Here comes Marler once again around the bottom. He's going to slide up in front of B.J. Robinson.
It's staying around 1.6 seconds. The telltale is going to be when they get clean air. Can Davenport drive away from Marler, or can Marler continue to reel him in as we approach 40 laps to go here tonight at Magnolia Motor Speedway?
Still cars all in front of them as they work their way down the front side here. Bronson trying to get around the C8 car of Timothy Culp.
Marler has to give up a little bit of ground to clear the 14 of Rasden. Back in third now, it's going to be Overton. Fourth, Bronson, but he's come under fire as here comes Dane Dakins working on him side by side for fourth off turn number four. Out front, Jonathan Davenport with 40 laps to go as he works out of turn number two.
That's right, 60 are complete, 40 laps to go here. And then I know you say Cotton taking 100. And Jonathan Davenport laying that right rear quarter panel right up by the concrete down here in three and four.
They'll work off the top of two down the back straightaway, and your top two can breathe a little bit. One lap car separates them, 2.7 seconds the difference as Davenport flirts with that wall through three and four, but he continues to stretch it out his advantage that time, 2.8 seconds. Even with the bobble, he's able to extend it.
He is bobbling off of turn number two down there by the concrete. Watch him up here in turn number four. A little bit smoother through that one.
You know your car's good when you're bobbling and you're still driving away from him. Although Marler just knocked 4/10 off of his lead on that last lap, as Marler found a little bit of traction that Jonathan hasn't yet.
Well, I tell you what, if they've got anything left, they're fixing to have to pull all the stops out here. You just about 37 laps to go.
And how about this? Marler just knocked another half second off of Davenport's lead. Mike Marler is catching your leader. Catching him and passing him might be two different things. This time by, last time it was 1.6 seconds. Off turn number four was 65 laps complete. The separation, 1.6 seconds.
1.6 seconds now as Marler has closed the gap as they go down the back straightaway. Marler watching that scoreboard. I guarantee you he's watching those laps to see if he's got anything left for that 49 car.
And now lap traffic becoming a reality again as Marler takes 2/10 off of Davenport's lead down to 1.4 seconds. Down the back straightaway, lap traffic, no caution. Nick Thrash, go to the infield. He does not. Caution will wave.
Well, that burn there, they can't hardly get those cars in the infield.
Caution on the Speedway, Ross, with 34 laps to go.
Caution rolling out for Nick Thrash in the 27 car.
Michael Page goes pit side. We also see Brian Rickman go back pit side.